Rockwood. And so I looked at it and I ran the probably about 10 and I liked it, but I kept going back to that Rockwood and I liked that price. And then I said, "Babe, what you think?" She said, "Well, I like that." And I said, "That one kind of laid back, kind of look like me. Look kind of cool." I said, "It ain't too big." And then first of all, I can get in the small driveways. So I don't want no real long, because the other one's more longer, you know, wider. I mean, longer and a little wider. And I wanted that one. I said, "That looked pretty cool. Look like a little baby lowrider RV. And I can get in little tight places." And I said, "Okay." I called the man about the RV. He told me about it. And he said, and then when something is meant for you, and I was like, it was like on a Thursday, and I told him, I said, "Can you hold it about a Saturday?" Or he had somebody to come look at it. Remember I told you I was going to look at the RV? They're coming out. They might go and pick it up or buy or purchase it. Turned around. The man said, and then, I'm going to get to that good part. Lisa said, I said, okay, we're going to go. We made the journey. I said, okay, I got my wife. No, well, she's my girlfriend now, fiance. Then we weren't married, right?
Yes.
I'm getting it right?
Yeah, you got it right.
Then we turn around. We on our way. I got my best friend with me, Les, that traveled with us. I paid him and fed him. Come on, man, come on in. And we was on our way to Tennessee. The man said, "He'll hold it for me." Then by the fact, he said, "I'm going to just hold it for you." So the other guy didn't show up that Friday. So I told him I'd be there by that Saturday, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Went there by that Saturday. But you said, boy, he had held that thing for us. And what do you want, $5,500 for one? And I think I ended up getting him like $4,500.
Yeah.
So something like that. Cause he had some little problems with the issue. Then Nisa, when we pulled up, my fiance's best friend at that time said, "Frank, they came way out here to buy this piece of the other word, but I'm gonna use crap." And we got it and we made the deal. We on our way back in the RV. The top came apart on the RV and the window was, had been broken. The man said, "That's why I got the price knocked down, because then the window was up." Was out of it because his son hit it, was playing baseball and hit the window. So we knocked it down, got it down about $4,500. And we on our way back. We ride. We put plastic up to the window. We riding in the RV. But I said, "Yeah, I'm so happy. I ain't never had me an RV before." Well, I got in the RV, we ride. Me and Liz. My wife and her best friend and the other car behind her. Next thing I know, the plastic came off the window and my partner was over there asleep. My best friend, and the plastic hit him in the face, and I'm still dry. He said, "The plastic hit me and woke him up." He said, "Oh man, don't worry about this, keep dry." I said, "Man, that plastic might just smother you." "Oh, it ain't gonna do nothing. It ain't gonna kill me." And I said, "Man, put the plastic back on." "Oh man," he tore the plastic off. He said, "Keep driving this thing. Let's get home." Boy, we arrived. Boy, and he holding the plastic up. I didn't tore it out. He put it up, just took his arm and just held the plastic.
All the way back.
And next thing I know, I heard something rattling up on the RV.
What?
The tower coming apart. That tower was coming apart on the RV. I said, "Oh man, I made a bad investment. Might be right here." The tire looked new, but I guess he hadn't drove it in a while. They said he had just came off a trip from Florida.
Dry ride.
Boy, that tire came loose. And I said, "We're gonna have to pull over to the truck stop." "Hey, we're gonna have to pull over to a truck stop to get this off here." Go. He said, "Man, all we gotta do is get a knife or something and cut it off." Boy, and we figured that out. We got something, I think, from one of the truckers when we cut that part off. We got back in. He said, "Let's go. Keep it going. We're gonna take it on in just like it is." Yeah, my first RV. And, We made it on back to Birmingham. We made it back to Birmingham. Everybody, we made it back to Birmingham probably about 2 o'clock in the morning. Wasn't it about?
Yeah.
About 2 o'clock in the morning. Everybody tired. Sleeping.
It was sleeping in the back while you were driving.
No, he was in the front seat. And he was, well, we had so much fun, we got it back.